Discharge summaries are crucial in the continued care of a patient once they leave the hospital. The patient's primary care provider is able to understand what workup was done and what therapy was given in the hospital. It also helps them understand what they need to follow up on and what the plan of care is once the patient is back home. It is important to have thorough yet pertinent information. For example, the PCP may not care that the patient was on 1 liter of oxygen for a day, and then up to 2 liters, and then back to 1 liter, and so on, but will care to know if the patient is going home on oxygen or if the patient required intubation during their hospitalization. In the next few slides, we will review how to fill in the important components of a discharge summary on MEDITECH. Discharge summaries must be completed within 24 hours of discharge. This is to ensure that PCPs have access to accurate summary in a timely fashion. It is also good practice to ensure that you do not fall behind on documentation. There is a helpful discharge summary template in the PHM Resident Handbook. It has helpful hints about what details to include in a summary. You will likely learn during your orientation that when documenting on MEDITECH, you can either type or use the Dragon dictation system. In either case, you need to be sure to check all your spelling and that everything makes sense before you save a document. It is a little more challenging when using Dragon because you just talk into the device and it types everything out for you. It is very important you read everything to make sure it all makes sense. Sometimes it doesn't understand the speech or the words and it will type absolute nonsense. Always review your work before saving it. When you make the decision to discharge a patient, you need to enter discharge instructions and discharge orders first. Click on the discharge tab on the right-hand column. Let's review the main components. Anticipated date is required, and this will also ask for an anticipated time. These are estimates and do not have to be exact. Discharge disposition will almost always be home, self-care, but may occasionally be psychiatric facility for patients transferred to inpatient psychiatric care after medical clearance. The POM discharge order is the official discharge order, while the rest of this screen are the details surrounding discharge. You can fill out all of these details and leave the POM order until you have discussed the discharge with the attending, they have evaluated the patient, and have given you the okay to place the POM discharge order. Occasionally, the ability to formally discharge a patient may be on hold for an additional event. For example, you may see a patient with asthma in the morning that is discharge ready but still needs asthma education. In these cases, you can use the yellow post-it note under anticipated date to note discharge once family receives asthma education. This is helpful for nurses to prepare for the discharge and not have to call you to put in the orders when the patient is ready. These post-it note conditions for discharge should be for minor concrete events, such as discharge after 2 p.m. dose of Rocephin or discharge after a follow-up appointment made by care coordinator. You should not use this for anything you need to assess, such as discharging after good oral intake or discharging after patient is at baseline mentation. It is also a good idea to verbally communicate any discharge conditions you list in the post-it to the nurse so that there is no confusion. Discharge medications will allow you to reconcile all home and inpatient medications and to prescribe new medications so that it is clear to the family what medications they will be taking after discharge. It'll also allow you to prescribe and refill medications. Finally, under provider documentation, you will be able to provide more instructions to the family, which we will look at in a moment. When you complete this screen, you must click Finalize RX Orders at the bottom. Clicking on Provider Documentation will take you to this screen. All components should be completed. It is important to be as specific yet concise as possible. Families are usually exhausted by the time of discharge from lack of sleep, stress, and information overload. Your documented instructions will greatly help to continue to care for their child. Most patients should follow up with their PCP after discharge for reevaluation and for the PCP to continue outpatient care. For return precautions, think about what symptoms would alert you that the patient's condition has worsened or that the patient may have a new complication. Diet instructions for G2 patients should detail the feeding regimen. Under additional instructions, it is helpful to include a short statement of what the patient was admitted for, along with an idea of what to expect at home. Once you have finalized the discharge order, you are ready to enter a discharge summary. When you open a patient's chart, click on the Document tab on the right-hand column, then click on Enter New. Initially, you will have to search for Pediatric Discharge Summary. After the first time, you can add it to your favorites list. Asterisks mark the required information. When you open the discharge summary screen, MEDITECH automatically enters the current date as the date of discharge. Please make sure this is the correct date. If you start the summary the day after, it will have the wrong date, so you need to edit this. To avoid this, open the discharge summary as soon as you enter the discharge orders and save it as in process. Make sure the attending physician name matches the discharge attending for that day and that you have the correct primary care physician's name. Include the field and names of subspecialists involved in the patient's care. This helps PCPs to know who cared for their patient and who the patient may need to follow up with. Time spent on discharge should almost always be more than 30 minutes. Take into account time rounding, counseling the family, discussing with subspecialists, and typing discharge instructions, and use this time. Make sure that the information you type in the hospital course makes sense. Imagine being in clinic and seeing a patient for a hospital follow-up. What information would be important for you to know? If the patient was here longer than 5 days, or if the patient is complicated or has many medical problems, it may be easier to type the summary by systems so you don't miss anything. Add all the diagnoses using the drop-down menu. You can add additional ones as well. Complete the patient condition portion. When you click Edit on scripts, you will populate in discharge medications from your discharge order. If the patient has subspecialists to follow with, especially if they are outside of CHOFSA, add their information to send them a copy of the discharge summary as well. The PD tab should automatically populate from your discharge order. This is why it is important to complete and finalize your discharge order before you start the summary. The last part is the exam. Make sure you review it and you only fill in the parts you actually examined on the day of discharge. The exam carries over day to day, so if you have a finding that was present on admission but now is resolved, it should not be on the discharge exam. Make sure you fill in the height and weight, especially for a patient who needs these followed closely, such as those with failure to thrive or nephrotic syndrome. The PCP may not have access to MEDITECH and may not be able to see this information on the top of the screen. Now you are done and you can click on Save to save your work. The attending who you choose to co-sign your note will now be able to add their addendum and co-sign it.